in the pits here at the National Hot Rod Association looking for cool cars, and I have got one for this. Check out this Plymouth Savoy, the Wild Wild Wedge of Mr. Eric Bell. Eric, this car is absolutely fantastic. I love what we're seeing. I want to get closer to it. When did you get this car? Tell us a little bit about it.
I bought it about 3.5 years ago from, it was original Honkin' Hemi from Tony DiPillo. He had sold it to somebody, and I bought it from him, and I was just going to do a few things to it, and then it got out of hand, and it's really been restored from bumper to bumper, and been racing it now for a little over a year.
It was the Honkin' Hemi, now it's the Wild Wedge, so you've tipped us to one of the changes you made.
Yeah, that's one of the changes. I didn't really change a whole lot beside the engine. I mean, it did have a 4-speed in it, so I had to change it over to an automatic. And we cut the funny car cage out of it just to get some weight out of it. And then, of course, it's been painted, but it's just basically a copy of the paint job. The car's been a race car for so many years, and I thought I kind of owed it to the car to have the same paint job instead of, you know, doing something new or newer style. So I tried to make it as nostalgic looking as possible.
Well, it is very nostalgic looking, and hopefully everybody out there can see it. This thing is a perfect tribute to, like, the old school look from the what appears to be hand lettered paint. Yep. Just everything is amazing. And this is an aluminum front end car. These are very rare.
It is. The whole front end's aluminum. It does have aluminum door hinges and bumper brackets also, but yeah, they're hard to come by.
Yeah, hands off, as in, if you put your hand on it, you could dent it.
Definitely. You definitely can dent it. It's kind of a funny, quick story. I went and got all the stuff locally in Phoenix, dipped and stripped all the aluminum, and I had them in the back of my truck, and I swear they were maybe going to fly out. They are light with no paint in them, on them, so you got to be careful.
Can we see under the hood?
Sure.
All right, let's see under the hood. This thing is amazing. Eric Bell going to open it up for us. The Wild Wild Wedge. Yeah, so not a Hemi, it's a wedge, but it makes a lot of power. What's the best ET and speed?
Today I ran pretty darn good. It's not the best, but I mean, we all know that it's hard to go real, real fast here because of the humidity, but I've been 912 with it, like 143, I think.
That is moving out. Beautiful under the hood, and just to think, the 1964 Savoy. These cars on the street, it was almost as if they were waiting to become drag cars.
You're right, because before that, they all looked like grandma and grandpa cars. They were real, especially Savoy. It was a real plain, basic-looking car, but that's why they made them factory race cars, because they were so stripped down and they didn't weigh a whole lot. So, yeah, they're one of my favorite cars, definitely.
All right, can we see you in one of your favorite cars?
Can you do what?
Can we see you in it?
Oh, see me in it?
Yeah.
Sure.
Let's do it. Eric is going to climb in. The Wild Wild Wedge, this thing is just spectacular. The interior, beautiful, the all red, like old school back in the day. You know, nowadays they want to make the interior of every car like beige and tan. Not back then. They went wild red.
Exactly. Kind of one of my things. I have a Challenger that I did the same thing with, and it's got the replica Hemi material, so I try to make the seats look like they're original seats instead of aluminum racing seats, and of course factory style carpet, and we got all the gauges and stuff restored and all that. So yeah, I just try to make it look like it came off the showroom floor as much as possible.
All right, walk us through your procedure. Like, you're getting ready to make a run, getting ready to go down the racetrack. Got the old school wheel, looks awesome. It's amazing that they were like that. Tell everybody what you do when you're gonna make a run.
Well, I'm in first gear, and once you light both lights, you push the trans brake button, and I mash the throttle, and to leave the starting line, I let go, and off you go. It's got an air shifter, so it'll do the 1-2 and the 2-3 shift, so at that point, you're just kind of holding on.
That is awesome. Can we hear it run?
Sure, if it will. No, it should.
It should. Do you need the power?
I need power.
All right, I'm going to go do my thing. This is it. I baited him into this. I love turning on the power back here, guys. Here it is. We got power, baby. That's my job. I love having a job. Eric Bell's Wild Wild Wedge, an amazing piece of machinery. One more thing, Eric, before we let you go, that we haven't told anybody out there. You used to have another profession other than drag racer. What was it?
Well, I did. I played professional baseball for 15 years, parts of 6 years in the major leagues. So, yeah, that's what I kind of did before I did this stuff.
Okay, like the experience of being on the mound, you were with what, the Orioles? Who else were you with?
I was with Baltimore, Cleveland, and Houston.
Being on the mound, staring down a vicious hitter, from what I understand, you partook in a no-hitter at some point, or at least had one going through seven. That experience of competition, that mentality, versus what you're feeling out there on the starting line when you got the stage bulbs coming on against a competitor, a tough competitor, a Justin Lamb or something in the other lane. Are they similar? Explain.
You know, they're similar. I would say working up to racing or pitching, it's probably tougher on you mentally to pitch. But once you get in the car or get on the mound, it's the same old stuff. It's you against them, and you're trying to beat the hitter. You're trying to beat the Justin Lamb in the other lane.
Thank you so much for sharing your car and a little bit of your story, Eric.
All right, no problem. Thanks for having me.
That's why you come out in the pits here at the National Hot Rod Association.